Today we'll be solving problem F from Codeforces Round 538. For detailed problem statement, follow the link in the description. So what the problem wants to say is, we are given n, which is basically the number of elements, which is 4, 5, 9, 1 and 2. Now we have 4, this is the number of queries. Okay, so we have 4 queries. There are 2 types of queries. One is torsion, L and R. So in the range L to R, you need to product all the elements present and then you need to return the torsion value. Okay, and the multiply is from L to R, you need to multiply all the elements with this given number 3. Sorry. Okay, so let us see what this is doing. So the first query is torsion 3. Okay, so what is the third element? Third element is 1. Okay, so this is 1 index. So third element is 1. So what is the torsion? Phi of 1 is 1. So the output of first query is going to be 1. Then torsion of 3, 4. Torsion of 1 and 2. So first we will multiply this. So second query wants us to do 1 into 2, which is equals to phi of 2. Okay, and what is phi of 2? Phi of 2 is 1. What is phi is basically, phi is the torsion function which gives you the number of elements from 1 to n which are O prime with n. So for 2 we start with 1. Okay, so 1 is O prime with 2. Okay, so this is the only number that is O prime, so the answer is 1. Now the next query is multiply. Multiply 4 to 4 by 3. So we multiply this element with 3. So how the array will change? It will become 5, 9, 1, 6. Okay, now in the next query we are asked to return the torsion of this element. So what is going to be the phi of 6? So how many elements are relatively co-prime from 1 to 6 to 6? 1 is co-prime. 2 is not co-prime. GCD of 2 and 6 is 2. 3 is also not co-prime. 4 is also not co-prime. GCD of 4 and 6 is 2. 5 is also co-prime. So now we have 2. 6 is not co-prime. So we have 2 numbers which are relatively co-prime. Okay. So this is what they want us to do. Now it is good to look into few things. Like if you have n and you want to find phi of n, then it is equal to n multiplied by product of all the primes that it has. So this is the formula. What is it doing? So this p is the number of primes that are available in that number. So let us look for 6. What is phi of 6 going to be? It is going to be 6 into, how many primes do you have in 6? We have 2 and 3. These are the only 2 primes that we have in 6. So 2 minus 1 by 2 into 3 minus 1 by 3. Okay. So what is it going to be? It is going to be 6 got cancelled. 1, 2. It is going to be 2, which we got here. So this is the formula. Now our question wants us to find this torsion function for product. Okay, so what the question wants us to find is, it is wanting us to find for A of I, where I ranges from L to R. So if we put the same thing in this formula, what we will get is, this thing is going to be n. So this is our n here. I is equals to L to R A of I. Now we need the primes in this product. Okay, so we have product of P belong to P, then P minus 1 by P. So this is what we need to find in case of this torsion function. And a multiply is multiplying L to R with this value. So we will use segment tree to solve this problem. So first of all, let us look into this problem without having lazy propagation in it. So what is going to be the structure? Okay, so in one node we'll have a value in it, and we want to have long
mask. Now what is this long prime mask? This prime mask is basically a bit mask which is storing the information about what all primes will be present. So how can I store this in a long? Because AI was given to be maximum 300. Okay, so the number of primes less than equals to 300 are 62. So I have 62 primes, and as long takes 64 bit, so I can bit mask that and store it in that long prime mask value. How? So your prime mask is going to be a 64 bit number. Okay, say I have calculated all the primes, all the 62 primes, and I have given the first prime the index 0, the second prime the index 1. So similarly, if my 0th bit is set, that means the first prime is present in this number. If this is 0, this is 0, then again this is 1, that means first, second, third, fourth. Fourth prime is there in my number. Likewise, we can store that whole information about the primes in just one long integer. Okay, so now this is going to be the structure of the node. Now how we will be moving the information upwards? Okay, so if this is my node, if I have val 1 and val 2, let us call this L value and this R value. This is the value in the left part of it, and this is the value in the right part of it. Similarly, I will have L prime mask and R prime mask. Okay, so now we'll push this value upward. We'll get value and prime mask here. Okay, so how will we be calculating this? To calculate the value, okay, we just need to multiply L value with R value. If we multiply this, we can store this value in L. And for this prime mask, you just need to do OR operation. If you do OR operation, then you can store that if, say, like primes 2 and 3 were present here, and prime 5 was present here, then here you need to store that 2, 3, and 5 are present. So that is simply ORing those two long prime mask values. So using this, you can solve it. But the problem is, how will you do this multiply operation? For multiply operation, you need to do range updates. Okay? So if you do the range updates and apply this, then what you have got is, this value is having this thing, and this prime mask is having all the primes. If you apply this formula here, like you take the value and multiply it with, you take all the primes, p minus 1 by p, and you keep multiplying that, you can answer each query. So the only problem for now that we are having is this multiply operation. So we need to do range update, and if we do range update, it will result in time limit exceeded. Okay, so what we can do is, we can apply lazy propagation here. Okay, for lazy, for this val, we can have one more lazy thing here. So I will add int modify, and for this prime mask I will store long push mask. Okay, now these two are required for lazy. What you do in lazy is, you don't update the nodes until and unless it is required. You only update them when it is required. So if you get a multiply operation, okay, so you will take the mask, okay, and you will push it to push mask. If it is not required to update as of now, you will take the number, you will put it in modify if it is not required right now. But when it is required, you will again take the values from the modify and you will update the val. You will take the values from the push mask, you will update the prime mask. Similarly, whenever it is required, you do the operations. Okay, so by using this, you can get an accepted in this. For implementation details, you can follow the link in the description. Happy coding.